Hello. This is the fourth methodology talk, and it's about the hands and the fingers. And it seems not so important as the previous one, but it is a very important point for a dancer to have the hands and the fingers in the correct posture, in the correct form, because when you are looking at a dancer and you do not look on purpose to hands and fingers, but you have to look at them, then you can almost be sure that they are held wrongly and moved wrongly. It's a very difficult thing also for youngest, because there is no effort, no muscular effort. How easy is it when I think, okay, I'm taking this heavy thing. I use my muscles. But using your fingers and your hands does not need any effort. It should look spontaneous and relaxed. An arm should get a longer line by the hand. If you take all the eyes to your hand, then you hold them wrong. It's the end of your line. It's the, in the round positions we mentioned before, it's the fingers are walking in each other, End of the line. Remember, armpit, elbow, wrist, little finger. So the bottom of the hand, also the little finger, is very important. In the allongé, the little finger is looking in the line of the outside of the arm. So in an arabesque, it is very important to hold this line straight and not look, then the line is away. Yes. Now, how to group these fingers? Your palm of the hand is in the line of the round arm or of the reaching out arm. But the fingers, you have five of them, and they should not be broad, because otherwise, look, that's horrible, that is like a frog. A dancer like a frog, we do not want that. So we have to give them an elegant look. What are you doing in ballet? Your hands should be really relaxed. And then your middle finger is coming in. And your thumb, your relaxed and not bended thumb, is going to the third phalange, so the one what's much near to the palm of the hand, is moving there. Your index finger and your ring finger are in the line of the back of the hand. You see, it's the same line. And the little finger is coming a little bit out. So this is the finger resting on the air in first and in second position, is making my line in the third position, is stretching out when I do an allongé, an étendu, or here an allongé in first. Now, for youngsters, it's very difficult, and I have a nice exercise. What helps? That helps. So we are doing an exercise, making a little heart. Taking both hands, you can sit on the floor, but I won't do it now, and we take the palms of the hands in front of the body. Then we roll to the last phalange of the third finger. The finger rolls, look, and now you are making a little form of the heart. You can do this in nice ballet music, for example, in a 6-8, and a 1-2-3-4-5-6, 1-2-3-4-5-6, four, five, six. So it's really, this is a little tension, and now you get this relaxed hand you want to have. Now, the difference in the arrondi hand and in the étendu hand, I told already before. In the arrondi, you make you perfect the round form of the arm, and the hands are walking into each other. In the allongé, you give the line of the lower arm is going out and reaching through the whole room. So you need this also in the arabesque positions, and we will talk later about them. So I hope this is clear. You can reach me by internet if you have further questions about it. Thank you.